What are your thoughts, Dave, as our provincial Grand Master, on the likes of the Light Blues Clubs and other organisations that the younger brethren in Lincolnshire are doing to keep the interest of the younger brethren going? Talk to me.
I think it's fantastic. I've seen some of the things that the Light Blues get up to, and of course I can't qualify because I'm old and decrepit, but things like go-karting, curry nights, quiz nights, I love going to those sort of things anyway. And I have been invited to a few of the Light Blues events, and unfortunately they've always clashed with something else, which is a real shame. I'd love to go. I think, again, the future of Freemasonry depends on people enjoying what they do, and that's another form of enjoying what we do. But I do think there's a really... a difficulty in as much as that the Light Blues have to manage themselves, and that could be another task and another thing to organise on top of all your other Masonic commitments. So we would like them to be self-managing, and in some areas that works really well. In other areas, people like to go to events that have been organised for them, and I would encourage any centre to hold a Light Blues evening, whether it's a very successful club at Boston or whether it's the Grantham Curry Club, which seems to be equally successful, but in a perhaps a less organised way.
Yeah, we at Grantham, we've decided to allow darker blues in if they've got the right mindset. And it's been absolutely fantastic for, because let's be frank, at festival boards, the older, you know, the older brethren tend to stay together.
Yeah.
And it's great to have, they might be old in body, but young in mind, to mix with the younger brethren and actually get some interaction.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, there's still a hierarchy at the festive board, and in my own lodge, I don't sit on the top table. I refuse to sit on the top table because I like to mix with different people. Having said that, every other meeting I go to officially, I have a place to sit, and I have to sit where I have to sit. And I accept that. But if I was out with my friends for a curry, then I would sit where I wanted to and who I sat next to. And
well,
I enjoy curries.
There is actually an initiation ceremony for the Grantham Curry Club. Of course, like all Masonic secrets, we can't tell you about it until you get through the door.
Please don't. I have been notified of a couple of dates, and again, it's clashed with other things, but if I'm able to come, I would love to
Well, you'd
come.
Be pleased to know that Peter Brooks, your right-hand man, is keeping an eye on us young'uns, and it's been absolutely fantastic because what it has enabled us to do is actually bring new members in because they've actually got to know...
Yeah.
And we can have a bit of leg pulling about the ceremony without giving the secrets away, and there's no surprise.
I think a bit of banter, as long as it's not personal or nasty, but a bit of fun means that people see that Masons are having a good time, and they know that if in the company of Masons who are having a good time, that they'll have a good time.
Do
as
you
well.
Think we should be a little bit more public about our membership?
I think we are trying to be more public about our membership. I mean, the open days have been a great example. I've been to quite a few now. And that is a fantastic opportunity to get people to approach us. But I also think we should be more outgoing ourselves. And we've just launched an initiative to encourage anybody who wants a guest speaker at any particular organisation, if they're struggling for a guest speaker, let us know and we'll go and talk about Masonry.
Excellent.
I think it's essential that we do that.
Thank you very much.